North American title.
So we are split so far, correct?
That's correct. Let's go to the ladder match. There's a ladder match for the vacant NXT Tag Team Championships. People that follow know that the Viking Raiders gave up the titles as they now are a main roster team. So there's four teams involved in this ladder match. It's Oney Lorcan and Danny Burch, the Street Profits, the Forgotten Sons, and the Undisputed Era of Kyle O'Reilly and Bobby Fish. It's a four-way ladder match.
Wait, I'm sorry. The Viking Raiders are not in this match.
Correct. They are not in this match.
Wait a second.
This guy.
Hold on.
Pull up the notes, buddy. I know you got notes.
Hold on. Here's my thing. We usually salivate over the wrestling and the storylines in NXT. They usually do a great job. This storyline is anus. The Viking Raiders, right? Viking Experience? Viking Raiders. War Raiders. War Machine. What's their name?
Viking Raiders is their latest name.
Okay. The Viking Raiders. It end in a schmoz finish against the Street Profits?
Yes. And then a schmoz finish. And that show, that after the match ended and there was a brawl, the show ended with them laying the titles down in the ring and bowing. And that was their last appearance in NXT.
Oh, I must have fast-forwarded through the bowing. Okay. So they haven't been on Raw lately, though, have they?
Not that I've seen, no.
Huh. Okay. Kyle O'Reilly and Bobby Fish, Red Dragon, win the titles. Going with my heart, Joe. Going with the ticker. Is it going to be Oney Lorcan and Danny Burch? Probably not. I wouldn't mind it if it was them. I also wouldn't mind it if it was the Street Profits. I think they've been doing a really good job. They're really good singles wrestlers, too, as you can see if you've been watching Evolve. I like those guys. I don't want it to be the Sons of Anarchy, whatever the hell their name is. I don't want it to be them. It's probably going to be. I don't want it to be. So I'm okay with anybody but the Rikers Island Jackson from Sons of Anarchy guys.
Forgotten Sons, right? Forgotten Sons. I'm with you on that. I would rather see anybody but them win. So that makes me think just because of that they might win. Yep, I don't think Lorcan and Burch will win. They have, they're invested elsewhere. I think, Lorcan is on 205 Live, and I know Burch appears in NXT UK. So for me, it's really down to Undisputed Era and Street Profits. I don't want the story of the night to be Undisputed Era losing everything. That would really be upsetting.
Since we're going to be there and we're so emotionally invested in them?
Correct.
Yeah.
So I think that what I think I've convinced myself is that they're going to have the Undisputed Era win the titles here, and they can have the Street Profits chase them and maybe have them fight the Street Profits at the next takeover and build to that. To me, that makes the most sense. A summer full of Kyle O'Reilly playing air guitar on the title belt, that would be amazing. So I'm going to go with Undisputed Era winning the titles here for the third time and hopefully keeping him for most of the summer.
As long as I have Bobby Fish yelling from the outside for them to put down their drink the entire match, I'm sold, man. I'm totally with you. All right, so we agree on that one, Undisputed Era. Yeah.
So in the NXT Women's Championship is Shayna Baszler versus Io Shirai.
Io Shirai. Shayna's got to lose it at some point, and here is now is as good as any. Io Shirai is really good in the ring. The Mia Yim, Bianca Belair thing, it's really not blowing my socks off. I'm actually kind of underwhelmed by it, unfortunately, because I really like Mia Yim. I think you have two options. You could either put on Io Shirai and then move Shayna Baszler along, or if you want to keep it on Shayna Baszler, the next contender for Shayna Baszler should be Candice LeRae. So those are the options. Candice LeRae takes it from Shayna Baszler, or Shayna loses it right now to Io Shirai.
Yeah, I feel like anytime we do these picks for takeovers and for the women's match, I always pick Baszler to lose, and it very rarely happens, if ever. So I'm going to say Baszler wins and hope that Io Shirai wins the title. But my pick officially is going to be Shayna Baszler.
Okay, my pick will be Io Shirai.
There you go. And that leads us to the main event. So the main event is a one-fall match this time between Johnny Gargano defending the NXT title against Adam Cole.
There's two ways you can go with this. I think you know the answer. It's a big swerve. Roddy helps Cole win the title, or Undisputed Era breaks up. That's how I look at it. There's only two options. Hunter is literally scratching a hole in the couch right now. He's such a good dog. Well, being that I'm going with my heart, Joe, I think what they're going to do here is they're going to have Roddy come in strong, act like he's going to turn on Cole, hit Johnny Wrestling. Thus, Adam Cole, baby, becomes your NXT heavyweight champion. So that leaves Adam Cole as your NXT heavyweight champion. You have Red Dragon as your tag team champions, and Roderick Strong should chase Velveteen Dream or Tyler Breeze. That's how I'm booking it. I want them to go 1985 Horsemen. Everybody's got the gold. Adam Cole wins the title.
Yeah, you know, first when this match was announced, I thought that Cole had no chance. I just figured, you know, Gargano finally won the championship after all that time of chasing it and his feud with Ciampa. And over the last 2 weeks, I've gone from Gargano definitively winning to Adam Cole maybe having a chance to, I think he's going to win the title. So I'm going to say Adam Cole wins the title. I just feel like that's really what I'd like to see happen. I think a lot of fans want to see that happen. And I think it, as you know, if Triple H wants to make this a memorable NXT takeover, that's a good way to do it. So let's have Adam Cole win the NXT championship this Saturday in Bridgeport while we're in the house, as they say.
Let's get Undisputed Era to hold all the gold. That's my guess. That's what I want to do. That's what I want to see. I'm paying for the ferry. We're paying for the hotel. We're paying to be there live. Give us what we want, Triple H. And what we want is the Undisputed Era to reign supreme over NXT. I'm looking forward to the show. It should be a lot of fun. It should be a good time. I'll try to. There's not really much going on in regards to like around NXT, it's like WrestleCon or stuff like that. So, you know, we'll be live tweeting some stuff out. I know there's going to be matches beforehand. So make sure you're following us on Twitter at All Night Long WP, Instagram, Twitter. We'll be taking pictures all night long. Ha! Nice. We'll be taking pictures all night long. And we'll have some dark match results, some possible spoilers if you're into that kind of thing. But yeah, man, I'm looking forward to the show.
Yeah, me too, buddy. I think that's it should be a good show. I'm not expecting anything less. And yeah, man, we'll be there in the house. So hopefully we make it to the ferry on the way back. That's the goal, if we can survive this weekend across the water. So we'll see, buddy. We'll see what happens.
Across the pond. Again, everywhere you could find us at All Night Long WP. Wrestling Perspective Podcast over on Blog Talk Radio. Follow us on iTunes. Give us a like, a subscribe, a rate, review, whatever the hell else you do, and a follow at youtube.com/allnightlongwrestlingpodcast. Until next week, unless we're dead, this is the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. He is the Stallion. I'm the Enforcer, and we're tapping out.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again, because a vision softly creeping,
oh my God,
left its seeds while I was sleeping, and the vision that was planted in my brain.